that was standing in the way of this discussion was the United States. I was very surprised to hear that.
And William, what is the understanding of why the U.S. would be against making any kind of payments?
Well, it's a very good question, and I put this question to Alden Meyer. He's a climate policy expert, and he has been at many of these UN conferences before. Here's what he had to say about that.
The fear expressed by the U.S. is that if we start to admit that we are on the hook to help these countries deal with the impacts of climate change, it will create an expectation of unlimited, open-ended liability and compensation for past emissions. That's the fear. But the question is, we need to find something in between unlimited liability and paltry sums of money. That's the challenge here.
So that's the issue in a...
This is tragic, predictable, and also stupid. This reporting is from the Glasgow Climate Conference. That's today's reporting from the PBS NewsHour. And I wanted to just explain a little of the context. The concept is climate debt. And the idea is that many nations, developed nations in the global north, the United States, if you're watching this video, have contributed to climate change issues have made climate change worse than other nations. One of Pope Francis's big angles on climate change is that the most vulnerable feel the impacts worse. There's the moral issue there, the climate justice issue, is that rich countries like the United States, while we are feeling wildfires and we are feeling hurricanes, largely speaking, we are insulated from a lot of the effects that are making climate change worse. So we made the problem and we're not feeling the problem as badly as other nations that are being asked to not use as many fossil fuels as we got to use to develop ourselves to the state that we're in now. So on the table in the Glasgow discussions is the question of whether or not the United States owes money to developing nations that now cannot emit as much carbon as we were able to emit as we were developing. It's a legitimate and important question, and this response is, as I said, predictable and so dumb and so characteristic of like how people with privilege fail to take accountability about things. What the reporter is saying, this expert is saying at the panel, is the U.S. is unwilling to admit that we have caused climate change more than other developing nations that didn't have gas-guzzling cars for decades and decades and decades. Because if we were to admit that, then, oh, well, unlimited liability, we'd just be paying everyone infinite amounts of money. Like, come on. Just, come on. This is ridiculous. We pride ourselves on being a center of innovation. We made the internet, we made the light bulb and all this jazz, and yet we refuse to take accountability for the fact that those inventions are now destroying the world.